Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to see how can we modify the existing data flow which is having a lot of transformations and a lot of complex linking between the transformation nodes. Okay, so let's start with one data set. Here we are having the opportunity data set from the custom sales analytics template app. Okay, let me explore this. So if we can see, this is the opportunity data set, and if we are clicking on the bars, we can see the all the dimensions which is present in the opportunities data set. Okay, so by looking at the data set, we can know like this came from the opportunity object, and these are the direct fields from the opportunity because it is not having any dot notation. But if we can see these fields, this is having the dot notation of account. It means it is coming from the some other object. This account is nothing but the relationship name in the augment transformation. Okay, so let's assume that we have the requirement for adding the opportunity owner's login date. Okay, so if we can see in from the opportunity owner, we are getting the email, and we are having the name, and we are having role.name. These details we are having, but we don't have the any last login date. Okay, so how can we add the last login date to this opportunity data set so that we can see that in the lens, or we can add that into the dashboard. Okay, so first we need to find out in which data flow this data set is created. Okay, so this data set, as I told you before, it is coming from the sales analytics template app. Okay, if we go to the all item, if we go to the app, so this is the custom sales analytics template. This is created by using the Salesforce sales analytics template. It is default, which is available. So if we can go to the data set, we can see the opportunity data set. So if we search with the same application name, we can find it out to the data flow. For seeing the data flow, we can go to the data manager. We can go to the data flows and recipes. We can just search with this name. So now we got to the data flow. Let me open the data flow. So if we see the data flow, it is very complicated and it is having a lot of transformation, and we don't have the accuracy where to add our last login date so that it will appear in the opportunity data set. So what we will do, we will go through the each and every transformation node and how it is related, but it is very difficult to go through this many data transformation and linkage. Okay, it will take lot of time, and finally we will get confused. Okay, so I am telling how can we handle this thing. Okay, let me go back to the lens. So what things we know like we need to add in the owner. So we need to get the owner's last login date. So we are already getting the owner information, but we don't have the last login date column from that owner. Okay, so first we need to find out the transformation which is forming this owner.email or owner.fullphotourl, so that we can check whether this field is available and we can add that field to the transformation. It is definitely the augment transformation which is joining the opportunity under the owner from the user data set. Okay, so we can search, we can download the data flow, and we can search with the owner relationship name so that we can find it out this transformation. So for downloading the data flow, we can just click on this download icon. I already downloaded it and I am having in the Notepad++. Okay, so what we need to do, we just need to search with the relationship name. Okay, so this is the data flow JSON that I have downloaded. Okay, so I have just entered the relationship and the owner. Owner is nothing but the relationship name that we saw in the lens. So we just need to search it. Okay, yeah, we find out the node which is having the relationship name as the owner. Let's check the node name. If we go to the top, we can see the node name. So here we can see join activity owner. But this join activity owner doesn't looks like it is related to the opportunity, because it is related to the active. So let's check whether any other augmentation with the same relationship with the owner and it is related to opportunity. So we found out another one with the same relationship with his owner. So here we can see the transformation node name join opportunity owner. So this is definitely, I think it's related to our opportunity owner opportunity, because it is having this name. So we can just search with this name in the data flow. Once we get to the transformation node, we can easily search it. So when we are searching, it will show the result in the center of the this canvas. So this is the result. We can just open and we can check whether last login date is there. We can go to the right fields and we can check whether last login date is there. So here also we don't see the last login date. It means we can't do anything with this transformation node. Okay. So basically this user, this is the field from the user object. So definitely we need to add that field in the, so when we are extracting the user details, so that it can be moved to the all the transformation. So after checking the particular node, what is the next step that we need to do? We need to find out the source node where we are extracting the user. Okay, so for finding out the source node, we need to find it out to the first transformation node. Okay, so for that we can just refresh this page, because if you're going like this, it will take the time. Okay, I'm just refreshing this page. So now we got for the extract quota. Okay, so first we need to identify what is the naming convention that we are using for the transformation node. Here they have used extract. So wherever the digest in transformation node that they are using, they have used extract. So what we need to find it out now? Now we need to find it out the extract user. So our is related to user object. So I am searching for the extract user. Yes, there is one node called extract user. Let's go and check whether this field is there. Let me open this. So this is the source node where we are fetching the user object fields. Let me select the fields. Last login date. Okay, yeah. This field is not selected. That's why it's not coming in our target data set. So let me select this field. Let's save it. So while saving, it will ask whether we need to propagate. If we are propagating, means this field will get added in the all the upcoming transformation. Yes, we need to add that in the all the transformation, so that it will get added to our opportunity dataset transformation also. Let me propagate. Okay, now we updated the data flow. We saved the data flow. Let me update the data flow. Update it. Okay, after that we need to run the data flow, then only it will get reflected in the data set. Let me run the data flow, go to the data flow monitor for monitoring this. This I ran already. Let me refresh this page. So if we can see, this is running all the sync which is available in the data flow. Okay, so it will take some time for running. I am pausing the recording. After that we can see. Okay, yeah, now it got ran successfully and it got completed in the 2 minutes. Okay, so now let's see our data set whether last login date is reflected or not. So this is our data set we were referring. Let me save this and refresh this. I have saved these lines. Let me refresh this page. Let me check for the last login date. Yeah, yes. So finally, this owner.lastlogin.date got reflected in our data set. So this is how we can add the fields in the complex data flow so that we can modify the dashboard elements. Okay. I hope this helps. Thanks for watching the video.